Good morning from beautiful Southeast Oklahoma. Welcome to Flyover News. Well, getting around a little bit. Look, no cane, no crutch. The leg is getting better, the broke leg. So it's beautiful down here. It's beautiful weather. I say beautiful weather. We had about 2.4 inches of rain through yesterday, the last 2-3 days. It rained again this morning just a little bit ago. Now the sun's coming out. It's supposed to be 90 degrees this afternoon. 94, something like that, about 80% humidity as it melts away all the rain. But yeah, the pastures are green, the grass is growing, life is wonderful. I need to mow. I'm gonna try to mow the riding mower today. I need to mow the tractor back behind the barn. It's real bad, it's deep, it's chest high back behind the barn. So got a lot of different things to do, but we are feeling better, doing better, getting back to our regular old Flyover News self. So thank you all for watching. We appreciate it. If you like this channel, please subscribe to it. Set your notifications, all that stuff. You guys know the routine. Thanks again. Okay, me and Cooper are on a morning drive. We're driving along. You know, I got up at 5 o'clock and it was raining when I got up. And now it says excessive heat warning. That's just crazy. But it's gonna be hot and humid again this afternoon. They're Jeremy's horses. Okay, so like you know, I had an accidental gunshot 19 weeks ago. I shot myself in the leg, dropped the gun, and this is what it looks like today. It's not too bad. The bullet went in right here, if you can see that, and it came out right here. And so this bone in here, there's still a separation. This bone kind of moves around. That's why it's got a big sore spot there. From the inside. It's not swelling anymore, or not very much. It swells a little bit at the end of the day. For a while I was wearing a compression sleeve fitting, and it's doing pretty good overall. It's got a pretty big bruise spot there. Probably be bruised for a long time. Doesn't look too good, but to be honest, I kind of don't care how it looks as long as it works, and it's starting to work. For those of you that are John Wayne fans and ever saw the movie Rio Bravo, I'm kind of like Stumpy. I'm the guy that walks with the limp, but the limp's getting better. So let's get busy. We'll go hook up the brush hog behind the tractor, and we'll see if we can do a little bit of mowing with it and get on with some stuff. Thanks.
Let's go.
Well, that big tree right there, it's dead. It's deader than a doornail. And it's a big, tall tree. Big tree. It's not been dead a long time, but it's dead now. And it's begun its process of dropping limbs, which we don't want, so I don't know. The problem with cutting it down is it leans that way. And we wouldn't want to ever fall it that way before. We don't want it to fall it over here across the fence either. And we don't want to fall it down there into the branch. We don't want to fall it the direction right here toward where I'm sitting. Don't know. Well, I'm on the other side of it now. It's kind of hard to see. I'm still shooting a little bit into the sun. It is a big, big dead tree. I don't know. I need to take it down sometime and make it fall out that way. But maybe I can start by taking that limb off. It's starting to drop big limbs underneath it. But yeah, we'll have to think on how to get that down in the right direction. That tree right there, that'll make a lot of firewood for us. That'd heat the house half the winter, probably. Yeah, the fire girl's trying to make that fire go. It rained about 4 hours ago. It rained about a tenth of an inch this morning, so I don't know if she's gonna get it to go. Last fall, the utility company, gas company, came through and took some trees out of the right-of-way. The right-of-way is very old, and really it doesn't service the houses. It just produces the well that comes through here. And so she's trying to get that to go. They piled a bunch of trees right there. Let's see if it can go, but I don't think it's going to go. I think we're going to have to wait until it's drier. Good thing about being wet is it's not going to spread anywhere, but I don't know if we can get it to burn or not. This is a Bermuda field. I mowed over this last Wednesday, so it's been a week ago exactly, and just mowed it about 6 inches high. Didn't hit the Bermuda grass. I just hit whatever weeds were left in it and the dead stuff that was standing, and it's like it took off. That's the thing about Bermuda. If you mow it a little bit, it's what it wants. That and rain. So it's been 94 degrees, 90 degrees, and raining. And right after I'd mowed it, I mean, it just took off. It's already seeding out. It's amazing what mowing it does. And I'm saying mowing, but I'm mowing it with a brush hog, on the back of my tractor. We got to cut all those up sometime. That's the big tree. It broke off right up there when my leg was still broke. I was out there on crutches, cutting it up to get it out of the way. We drug it all over there. There's a bunch of it to cut up, but we're gonna wait till it's not 95 degrees outside, see if we can cut it all up for firewood and split it. Okay, in about 1960, there was an old house out here by the road. This is out front of our place, out by the road, and it's set right in there where it's flat. And every year, daffodils still come up around. I mean, that was in 1960, and the house got hit by a tornado and blew it away. And you can see that Janice's dad built the house way back there a couple of years later. And this was an old water well. And so we checked this well last year. We had about 5 months of no rain last year, and it had water in it all the time. So we're going to measure it again, see how far down it is to the water. You can see it's not very far right now, and see how deep the water is. And this is kind of our emergency water. We've got rural water, and we've got a water well back there, but the water well would be, without power, would be hard to get water out of. So we're gonna, I think I'm gonna try to build a little box around this and seal it up. That lid is on it sometimes, but not very often. Okay, so we've got about 25 feet of rope. I think that's gonna be enough. We're gonna tie this rope if we can. We'll tie it to a rock. Try to tie it well enough that I don't lose the rock down in there. And then we'll use this rock to take it just to the bottom, and we can measure when it comes out. This fashion box is not out of work. Okay, that'll be good. All right, we'll drop it down in here. drop it down in here nice and easy. Right there's bottom. Okay, so this far from the top, pull it all up. Lay this out. So today it's got 13 feet of water in it, and 13 and about 5 feet to the water, and it's got 13 feet in it. So it's not a very deep well, but it always has water. Seems like last year when we measured it, it was like 10 and 10 or so, or about 10 feet down to it, but it had water in it all year. So it's a good well. We're gonna see what we can do to box it up and make it a little better. Okay, so I'm back from the lumber yard. I've got some materials in the back of the Ranger here. Janice is in changing clothes. I've got some posts that are cut down to, I think, pretty close to the right length. And we're gonna go out and start building around the old well and see if we can box it in and put a nice top on it that we can open up and drop a bucket and a rope and everything down it and retrieve water if we need to. So that's the goal. We'll see if we can get it done. Okay, we got four posts set, a little bit of concrete in them, and we've put the top part around. So we're going to take a break and then put some runners along about the middle of the post to help sturdy it all up, and then we'll start putting some stuff on top of it.
Hey, I'm gonna be the cotton picking, rage of the ace, and I'm gonna be a diamond someday. Chunk of
got it boxed in, got a top on it. We don't have the lid yet. We got to put a lid on it, and then we'll be in good shape so we can open it, close it, latch it shut. So that's our beautiful well cover. We'll probably paint it a dark brown so it kind of blends in. And then we're gonna make a two-piece lid for it, and we'll put some bracing under the middle parts of it. But we want it where we can open it up and fish water out of it, or where we can keep it latched and keep it shut, keep the cows or whatever out of it. Cows always knock this cover off all the time. Every time we put it up on there, they knocked it off. So this is pretty solid. The posts go in the ground about 2 feet. Some of them, a couple of them are 2.5 feet. There's concrete in there, 4x4 posts. So it should be pretty solid. We got it nailed and screwed both.